Hello YouTube, Cyclic Action here, and holy shit, where have I been? Well, I'm a student, so back when I started last summer, I thought, hey, I'll have lots of time, it's the summer. And was I wrong. So, I basically didn't do shit for an entire year. And I kind of regretted it, actually. I enjoyed making these videos. In fact, actually, part of the reason the Portal Mel story collection ended was because Bandicam here was so polite as to screw up one of the recordings a little bit. It wasn't that bad. I only lost an hour of footage, but I felt bad because, you know, Portal Stories was a puzzle game. And I kind of already completed the puzzles, and I didn't really want to go through them again and either pretend I hadn't completed them and try to ditch my way through, or just blaze through a couple puzzles and steal that from you guys. So, I chose for option three. I'm like, alright, I'll put down Portal Stories until I don't remember what the fuck was going on. Well, boy howdy, did I not remember. In fact, I still don't remember anything. But this here, this isn't Portal Stories, no. You see, I kind of just wanted to play something fun to get started with. And I mean, don't get me wrong, I enjoyed Portal Stories, but I love Metro. I've not played Metro in, well, I played Last Light like a year and a half ago, but I've not played 2033 since easily high school. So I thought, fuck it, let's do it, let's play some Metro. That's kind of where I am now, so this might be a little bit of a change. I kind of want to keep the same basic format, and I'm just going to run through, let my commentary roll, but Metro is a very different game. It's a very environmental game. That's what I love about it. So that's why we're going to be hopping in here, and we're going to be going right into the Ranger Hardcore mode. So for those of you who don't know, the Ranger difficulties on Metro basically get rid of all, if not completely all, of the user interface, and it's really immersive. It's an amazing experience, what it is. I absolutely love it. At least I remember loving it. Let's see if I still know what the fuck I'm doing. And Hardcore, basically, everyone's gonna die in a couple of shots. It's going to be a very brutal experience, which I enjoy, you know, and make up for the fact that I can't afford Doom. Another reason I'm playing old games. I can't afford to buy a new one. I don't know, maybe I'll do a vlog sometime to catch you guys up. But in the meantime, I've chatted on long enough. We've got some Russian subway tunnels. I'll fill in anything the game doesn't explain as we go. Yes, I do know that we're going into the Ultimate Challenge Hardcore mode. So, yes, you will not survive.
The tunnel grew colder. Millie and I were close to the surface now. Soon, we'd climb up into the howling wind to find our way through whatever nightmares were waiting there. My long journey was nearly at the end. But would I have the courage, the will, to see it through?
So it does start with prelude here, but actually before I continue, it did warn that we are not going to survive, and in fact, I'm going to make a very stupid decision here. I will be right back. You see, my father is a hobbyist brewer. So I thought I would take some of this vanilla vodka, can't see that there, vanilla vodka that he sent me, and every time I die, I gotta take a big swig of Russia's favorite treat for all of us. This is probably a terrible idea, but let's make it happen.
Hey, Artyom, when you left your home station, do you ever think we'll end up in a place like this? Not knowing whether we were about to save our world or send it straight to hell.
Hair. Too much hair. place is falling apart.
We'll have to get through the military outpost to reach the surface, until.
Alright, so the first thing I'm gonna point out here is that if...
Something's moving in the next room.
I know there's things, but we'll get to that in a second. One thing you'll notice is that I have no ammo counter or anything. But if you look in the bottom corner over there, my gun has an open magazine.
Open the door. I'll cover you.
Do I not have any ammo? I don't have any ammo. Never mind. All right, there we go. So basically, the game universe takes place, the apocalypse has happened. There was a nuclear war of some sort or another. And, well, there we are. Bullets. I'll stick with this gun. There we go. Oh, wow, I don't have a lot of ammo. What was the button to change? Oh no, that's all. Okay, there we go. There's not a lot of ammo in those clips. I've got 25 shots. Let's do this. And a few gas mask filters. Alright, so one of the things with this game is it takes place in the Russian metro. Because back in the Cold War, the Russians built their subway system to also double as a fallout shelter for the population, figuring that most people will be able to get to a subway station in time. And that's more or less where the game takes place, across these stations, hence the name, Metro.
Okay. Up we go. Seems like nobody's home. Before we hit the surface, put your gas mask on. Without it, it'd be like a goldfish outside his door.
Make sure there's no lies.
This is the Korolev performance.
Okay, let's mask up. You will notice the mask is cracked. The mask can break. It's a fucking terrifying experience. No, put it back on. Put it back on. That wasn't the button I wanted to press.
Suki, here they come.
Shit, I don't have enough ammo. Do I have a... There we go. A sidearm action. Nope, never mind. Now the advantage being that they are as weak as I am. Hardcore mode does put it both ways. Oh, okay, he needs my help. See, hardcore mode kind of seems to get rid of most of the prompts, too, so the fact that I don't remember what I'm doing means there will be a few moments of running around.
And here it is, Antonushka.
Come in.
So I got a timer for my filter. I need to keep my eye on that.
Contact. They should be in the vicinity of the tower now. Over.
Over. Nice little touch there. You could hear both the radio chatter and him. This game focuses a lot on the immersion, so I'm just going to shut up and let you enjoy it.
Glad to see you, Colonel. Did you hear that? Listen. What the hell is it? Colonel Falcon! stay calm.
Oh. You should be scared. We are surrounded. Shit, we're out of ammo. Knife fight some monsters. Now we're mostly not supposed to make it through that section, I guess. It's an unwinnable battle. But my mask is a little worse for wear now. Ah, fuck. Forgot about demons, I just had horrible flashbacks.
Was never easy in the tunnels, but it was our home. There was comfort in its routines, in seeing the same people day after day. But since the mutant attacks had escalated, fear ruled the station. I had just turned 20, and could never have imagined what would follow on the morning that my stepfather's friend Hunter arrived at the barricade.
So now we can start to get into a little bit of the world building now that we're not on the surface shitting mutants. I love this game's soundtrack, I want to add.
Artyom. Awake at last, I see. Hunter's on his way in. He should have news from the other stations. Come on.
Alright, so to give a little bit of backstory, the apocalypse happened about, I think it was 15, 16 years ago for Artyom. He was just young enough to remember He was just old enough to remember the day the bombs dropped. So memorials from the surface of the star are pretty popular because Moscow is in complete ruins. It was an obvious prime target for the bombs. Nice little touch, you can play the guitar. So Moscow was an obvious target for the bombs, but the bigger problem, of course, is that they have no clue who else survived. Communication's a little spotty. So the entire game's actually based on a book series, which they like to show off in the game. But it's got lots of little details in the world. Little bits like the fact that everything is kind of Russian equipment. Because it was all stock for the Russian military to try and survive afterwards, but they didn't know how long they'd have to last.
Yes, Nikolai. Disease. I've been through worse. I'm not good. What's your plan for that?
The station can't survive much longer if these attacks don't stop. You must do something.
What more can we do?
Apparently the place has been under attack. I don't remember that. I don't remember a long
time. Kill us all.
I do remember the dark ones, we'll get to that.
Sergei, have you seen my Sergei?
Another patrol was attacked last night. The hospital's full.
Gah. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I had to.
What about Alexei?
I had to head out to the. Okay, the people from everywhere keep talking to me.
Let's go,
so much ambient chat that I'm trying to not talk over. They're all just babbling about the dark ones and like.
Pieter,
That's you.
They won't tell me anything. I don't know.
I think he's in charge of the station, or he's important or something. Nothing I can steal here.
How are the wounded?
Not much improvement. Two died this morning.
The dark ones do not kill outright, but they damage a victim's mind.
Well, these guys have seen better days. So the Dark One's been screwing with people's minds.
It's Hunter.
Mutants don't knock first. Open the damn gate. Welcome to Exhibition, Hunter.
Thanks. Now close your gate.
It's been a long time, Hunter.
Good to see you, Alex. Hello, Artyom.
So, Hunter, what's happening in the outside world these days?
Not much. Most of what I hear is about the exhibition and the undead infesting your tunnels. Artyom, I met a trader selling old postcards of New York City. I thought of your wall.
Hey, he brought us a gift.
These are not the usual mutant creatures. This is something else. Something
hell?
Much worse.
Dark ones. Well, whatever in hell they are, my order has a motto. If it's hostile, you kill it.
The dark
Total
ones
alarm in the main vent shaft. They're coming in from above.
Shit. Just what we need.
Oh, something's happening.
Just behind the wall.
Kirill, take your group to the tunnels.
Alex,
Hunter and
we must stay here and defend the hall.
All right, Artyom, quickly, get a weapon.
Oh, okay, he left us a revolver. All right. Well, I guess we got a knife, too. Maybe there's a gun in his bag.
We never come this far into this station.
It's the hospital. They smell the blood.
Basically, I just need to not die here. I don't know why I checked my watch. Is that it? I have it maybe? I don't know. Okay. Go! We helped! It probably is wasted bullets, but close enough. Oh, yeah, there are more of you. Nope, not anymore, there aren't. At least headshots still work. Wait, I think I have ammo. Nope. Nope, that's all. That's all she brought. Well, at least the knife's still effective. Let's dance! Let's dance, motherfucker! I don't know where that came from.
Artyom, are you alright?
Of course. He's a dead eye shot, this one.
He says as I'm holding a knife. Maybe I stabbed him in the face, I don't know.
No dark ones here. Just the usual tunnel trash.
Even when you don't see them. The dark ones are there. Fear. That's their weapon. That's what made the new solaces run through the tunnels like rats. The dark ones are not simple mutants. They're homo novus, the next step in evolution. You've heard about survival of the fittest? Guess what? We lost.
What's happened to you, Alex? You can go like lambs to the slaughter. I'll hang on to whatever life I got with teeth and claws. And I'll take more than a few of your homo novus with me to hell.
You think you're some old movie cowboy? Have a look, Hunter. 10 soldiers trained in combat. Their bodies broken, their minds gone.
The Dark Ones! They destroyed the outer guard post!
So, the Dark Ones are basically waging a war of fear, as far as I can tell. So I'm gonna run this episode a little longer than the usual 20 or 30 minutes I aim for, just because there's a lot of story packed very densely in the beginning here. So we'll call this one wraps, I think, when we get going. Oh, wow. He's fucked up.
The devil knows what's happening out there, beyond your perimeter. I must go recon the situation. Listen carefully, Atium. If I'm not back here by morning, you must get to police station and find a man named Miller. Tell him what's happened to me, and what's stirring in the northern tunnels. Show this to Miller, so he knows I've sent you. I trust everything to you, Artyom. Don't let me down.
Now, I assume that he knew Artyom from before.
This threat must be eliminated, no matter the cost. Eliminated.
Because if he didn't know Artyom from before, this is kind of very, hey, I just met you, but here's the fate of the world. Whoops.
Hunter did not return. It wouldn't be easy to find an excuse
to
leave the station and travel to Polis, but I had given my word. I learned that the caravan was heading to Riga the next day.
Summer's fucking hot!
And guards assigned on for the ride.
Alright, so it looks like actually we're heading with these guys, so... Стучите колеса, кондуктор, нажми на тормоза. When did I stay waking up in this station?
Taking your time as usual, huh? Alright, grab your gear, go to the platform, they're waiting for us. I'll meet you there. Hey, Artyom, don't forget anything, huh? Вот стоц перевертаться, бабушка здорова! Вот стоц перевертаться, куча едка плод!
He's really enjoying that Russian singing. I like the little touch that we did actually put up the Statue of Liberty before we went through. There's not really much else to take, I think. This is the radio, I guess. Well, I mean, I can't take that, but that's interesting.
Hey, there's some nice music.
Oh! I don't think I've ever gone down this way before. So, there's a lot of chatter here, so I'm probably going to tone down the background audio. But, a little touch is that, one of the most common things they eat down here is one of the only things that will grow in the low light. Mushrooms! So they, well, it's a little morbid, I guess. They kind of take whatever they can get, and mushrooms will grow on just about anything. And this is kind of the staple food of the apocalypse. Meat does exist, but, well, you can imagine how expensive it is when space is limited, because a metro station has only got so much to it. I don't know what's in these bottles, but it could be booze. Another little touch, of course, that lots of the electric lighting that's being run off old nuclear generators and the like is being backed up just by gas lighting. Because, well, I mean, if you're growing mushrooms, you're going to have a lot of gaseous byproducts. Plus, later you'll see the animal farms and methane and that sort of stuff. Not really economical for us in the modern day, but when you're in the apocalypse and it's all you got, it's all you got. Yeah, see, there is meat. There is meat. It's pork. I guess maybe the animal farms are right the corner?
Look who's talking about dirt. Looking around.
So the other nice little touch I like is that they actually try to keep the place clean.
Concerning trade, communications, resources, and so on.
I'm sorry.
Most importantly, the northern tunnels will now be secured by our combined military units, a major step in defense of the metro system. As a sign of goodwill, the troops from Riga are already on their way here. We're counting on all our citizens to welcome our new allies and to offer them the same respect shown to our home guard. Thank you for your attention.
So there's another little good touch. There is actually politics and a political system and internal bickering in the Metro, which makes sense. They've been running for 15, 20 years and resources are getting pretty scarce. I'm guessing this is a prison.
We got no business here. Prison is a place for thieves.
Yeah. Stealing. Ooh. Stealing like is very heavily punished. Because again, there's barely enough to go around. Unlike kind of like your Fallout apocalypse, where it's like you've got all this space, but somehow you're still scavenging enough food outfit after 300 years. Metro Apocalypse is like, wow, 5 years passed and we've kind of run out of all the canned food. You know, there are people here, there are kids and like, they've grown up knowing nothing but these tunnels. I mean, Artyom barely knew much more than the tunnel. Our character here, Artyom. Well, I think we can buy guns.
Well, I presume. Not bad, at least.
I guess everyone knows it. So, another interesting touch of the Metro. Wow, this background audio is loud. I'm gonna turn that down again. Another interesting touch of the Metro is that their currency is pre-war ammunition. Basically, the military-grade rounds like that were brought down or stockpiled in the place are, you know, good, decent quality ammunition. Whereas the stuff that's hand-loaded and reloaded in the Metro, the common ammunition, it's dirty, it fouls your gun, and it doesn't hit as hard because you're using homemade powders as opposed to proper military nitroglycerins. So, they trade in those. They have an interesting interaction, though, because you can also still shoot your military-grade rounds, and they hit like a fucking brick. They're incredibly damaging. But you're trading away ammunition. I don't think we can afford anything. Cancel it. So, I don't think we can buy equipment. Oh, yeah, here's one of those guys. So these guys trade out the dirty ammunition for clean rounds. Basically, they're bankers. Almost. So much noise.
Go to the armory and get geared up.
Okay. Guessing that's an armory.
Hello, Artyom.
Ah, yes.
Okay, let's take a look. Submachine gun, 5.45 caliber, made in the armory. It's got poor accuracy and overheats like hell. That's why they call it a bastard gun. Use short bursts, Artyom. Help yourself to some ammo, too.
So the bastard gun's interesting because it's a Metro-made weapon. But unlike a lot of video game weapons, mechanically it's actually really sound for kind of that slap together out of shit type weapon. The fact that it jams up easily and overheats easily makes perfect sense considering that it's an improvised barrel. The magazine, while unorthodox, is actually mechanically sound.
Here's a universal charger to keep the battery powered.
Basically, I always have this fucking thing out.
And a gas mask. Put it on if you crossed any radiation hot zones. Army issue first aid kits, just in case.
These are pretty much the only thing in the game that are a little unrealistic. You basically dope yourself up with morphine every time you get shot.
Okay, you're supplied, my friend. Feel free to try out your weapon on my firing range. And you try not to stick out your head too much, okay?
I know there's one of these buttons. Get that off. One of these There we are. Little interesting touch that defined your objective. What you should do is you follow the drafts in the metro. You can see how my lighter is kind of pulling in this direction. You follow where your lighter goes, and you find your way to your objective. It's a really neat little touch.
How are you doing? You're looking good. I wish I was your age.
And we got a compass too. Useful, but not as useful in a tight underground environment. I have to remember what button that was.
One day we could go back up to the surface. I've never seen Moscow, just the old pictures.
Moscow's gone. Soon we'll be gone too. And the monsters will inherit the earth.
But there were other subways. In St. Petersburg, Minsk, and Kiev.
People might have survived somewhere else, or at least for a while. But 7 years have passed now, and we've heard nothing from them. The other cities didn't have defense rings like Moscow did. What a great city it was, St. Petersburg.
So lots of people remember the fact that apparently in their lore at the time, only Moscow had a strong nuclear defense system which blocked a lot of the missiles. Because even these fortified metros, if you hit them too hard, too many times, they'd collapse, and they did collapse, some of them still. So they figured the other cities fared even worse, because they can't get any communication outside of Moscow. As far as they know, they are the only survivors of the apocalypse. So, I mean, you know, Russia strong, Russia won, but, you know, would you call this winning? That's kind of the problem with nuclear war, you know, among all the others. Can I steal your stuff?
Come in, son.
Wow.
You're ready to set off.
Okay. Good. Apparently I'm supposed to be here. Does he have something to say?
You've probably heard that our station is creating an alliance with Riga. We're sending them a couple of rail cars with humanitarian goods, some weapons, and some miscellaneous gear. That's the cargo you'll be looking after. It's not a very long trip, and it should not be too hard.
He might have more to say, but I'm not sure how relevant it is.
What's your situation, man?
More mushroom farms. Mushroom farms, mushroom trays. And there they are. See, they do raise some animals in here. So apparently some very forward-thinking people managed to bring some livestock down with them. And yeah, they're popular pets just because they breed a lot, and then when they get old enough, it's meat.
What's your situation, man?
How about helping us out a bit?
Nah, you can deal with it on your
own.
There we go.
Artyom, here, move out.
Apparently, I need to talk to him.
So you're ready to move out?
Fight a man in that thing.
Are you ready? Well, let's go then.
So trade caravans are a thing too, it seems.
You take that seat, Artyom, and you, Eugene, take this one. Did anybody forget anything?
So, you get your gear? Let's go then. Hey guys, going to Riga?
Yeah, we are.
Can I get a lift?
Sure, but no free rides. You'll have to pull the lever sometimes.
I can do that.
Let's go then. Alrighty then. Good luck to everyone staying home, and to us too.
Oy.
Let's go.
Good luck to us.
So, are you ready to finally be somewhere else?
There we go.
Artyomka! Free at last, huh? Well, for as long as the ride takes, anyway. Should be fun. More dangerous. Even better, right?
Does it cut here? I think this is a loading screen now. There we are. Alright, so I'm gonna wrap this episode. Okay, you can hear this. You can hear this.
It troubled me that I hadn't told my stepfather the truth. I would not be heading straight back from Riga, but Hunter was depending on me.
Alright, so I'm gonna wrap the episode up here. It's actually surprisingly nice to be recording again. It's relaxing. I enjoy this. I enjoy kind of talking while I play, because I'm crazy like that. I know there's not really any of you out there right now, but I might as well chronicle these just for historical purposes. I don't know. YouTube's flooded with new upstarts. I'm just gonna do this for the shits and giggles, really. It's kind of fun stuff. So, I will see you all on the next episode. Till then, keep those cannons ready, folks.